Hello IP student, today our topic is Python Numpy Array. This is Python Numpy Array part 7. In our previous lecture we discussed about concatenation and a split of an array using different function. In this lecture we are going to discuss about concatenation and a split of an array using two different programs. So this is first program appear on the screen. Let us take them one by one. First line is import numpy as np. It means import is a keyword, numpy is the name of library, np is the alternative name of library numpy. So whenever we want to use numpy, we just write np in place of numpy because it is an alternative name of numpy. Then after dot sign, and after that array belongs to that library. So in second line there is a declaration of array using array function. Actually two dimensional array will be created after that statement, and again next line another array will be created. This is also two dimensional array using array function. Next line there is a print statement, and after that array 1 will be printed after execution of that statement. Similarly next two lines print array 2 is array 2. Now here the actual program begins. A1 is equal to np dot hstack array 1 and array 2. So we pass two argument array 1 and array 2 in function hstack, which means horizontal stack. So it concatenate to array 1 and array 2 horizontally. Next line there is a function vstack. Vstack is used, again two argument passed array 1 and array 2. So after that vertical concatenation will be done after that, after execution of that statement. And after that there is a function concatenate. So a3 is equal to np dot concatenate array 1 array 2 comma x0. So and next line np is equal to np dot concatenate array 1 array 2 comma x1. So a4 is equal to np dot concatenate array 1 comma array 2 x1. So a3 basically is a variable which belongs to concatenation of two array along x0 using concatenate function, and a4 contain concatenation of two array 1 and array 2 along x1 using concatenate function. So concatenate function basically is a combination of hstack and vstack. And in next line there are different print statement. So print a1, print a2, print a3 and print a4, different print statement are there. After concatenation if you want to print different array, then answer or output will be appear like this. This is the output after execution of that program. In this we can easily see that this is an array 1, first array, then second array, then concatenation of numpy using hstack function means horizontal stack. So horizontal stack or so two array 1 and array 2 concatenate horizontally. So first array contain element 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Second array contain element 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. And after concatenation of two arrays, array 1 and array 2, final answer is 0, 1, 2, 10, 11, 12, 3, 4, 5, 13, 14, 15, 6, 7, 8, 16, 17, 18. So this is the final output after hstack function. And then if you want to perform concatenation using vstack function, then there is a concatenation of two array, but these two array basically concatenate vertically. So after concatenation we get the element 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and 16, 17, 18. And concatenate using concatenate function concatenate along x axis 0, you get the output 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16, 17, 18. Now, look at the output. This output is same as that of VStack function. So we can say that whenever we concatenate two arrays along axis 0, it means VStack. And whenever we concatenate, we want to concatenate two arrays along axis 1, this is equivalent to HStack. So this is a very important point. So VStack equivalent to axis 0 and HStack equivalent to axis 1 whenever we want to perform concatenate using concatenate function. So I think now it is very clear to all of you, quite clear to all of you, different types of concatenation of two-dimensional array. Now let us take another example, and this example basically, or this program, belongs to split function. So different types of split functions are there: H split, V split functions, and then a split function. So let us consider it line by line. First line is import numpy as np. Import is a keyword, numpy is a library, np is the alternative name of numpy. In second line, there is a creation of two-dimensional array using arrange and reshape function. Using arrange function, we declared a one-dimensional array containing 24 elements starting from 0, and reshape function convert it into two-dimensional array contain 4 rows and 6 columns. It means 4 into 6, 24 elements. In next line, given array, there is a print statement. Again, there is line number 5. There is a statement a1 is equal to np dot h split. So actually, h split function is there. H split means horizontal split. It basically divide array into two parts horizontally. And name of the array is here is ary, and comma 2 means it divide array into two parts. And then if we want to print that array, means after H split function, then that array name is a1. Similarly, V split function, so a2 is equal to np dot v split ary comma 2, it means v split will be there, or vertical split will be there, and it divide basically ary array into two parts. So after that array will also be printed. This is a program. Next part of its program is a1 add to np dot h split ary 2. Now again h split is there, but there is a little bit change as that of comparison to previous one, and that change is there are two variables ary1 and ar2, because after h split function we get two arrays. So first array is assigned to ar1 variable, and second array will be assigned to ar2 variable. So after that we can also print ar1 and ar2. In similar manner, after vsplit function we finally got two array. First array is assigned to ar1 variable, and second array will be assigned to ar2 array. So next, the print statement are there. So this is the use of basically H split function and B split function. In next line, there is a split function. A split function. So this is very important function, and it is little bit different as compared to H split function and B split function. Here, index value of an array will be given, are given basically. And these values are 1, 4. So what is the meaning of it? Actually, ary is a name of array, and 1 to 4 is the basically 1 to 4 is the index value. So it contain 3 array after a split function, after execution of a split function. And first array contain index value from 0 to 0, and second contain 1 to 3, and next contain 4 onwards row wise, because by default in this case x is equal to 0 whenever we want to perform a split using a split function. So if x is not mentioned, by default x is 0. So after the execution of that statement a3 is equal to np dot split ary comma 1 comma 4, we get 3 different arrays. First array contain index value 0, second contain 1 to 3, and third contain 4 onwards. Next is split function along x is 0. There is a basically print statement is there, and here we get 3 different arrays. So first array is assigned to v1, second array is assigned to b2, and third array assigned to b3. So b1 equal to first array, b2 is equal to second array, and b3 is equal to third array. There is assignment of array, different arrays using 3 different variables b1, b2, and b3. After that, a split function along axis 1 is there. It is very much similar to as that of previous one, but the difference is that along axis 1. So along axis 1, a split will be there after execution of that statement. And rest thing are same as that of previous one. There are 3 different variables c1, c2, c3. After execution of a split statement, we get 3 different arrays. First array is assigned to c1, second is c2, and third array is assigned to variable c3. And after that, only the print statement are there. So only these 3 arrays will be printed after execution of that statement. Now, output is there after execution of that statement. It is array 1, and we create this array using arrange and reshape function. And using reshape function, we decide its size as 4 by 6. So there are 4 arrows and 6 columns, and total element are 24. Now horizontal split. This is horizontal split. Actually, that is the main difference when we assign a single variable and we assign more than one variable, or actually different variables equal to the number of partitions. So since there are only one variable, so after split function, array look like this. This is first array after h split function, and this is second array after split function, because after split function, h split function, there are 2 different parts. So this is part 1 and this is part 2. Next is vertical split. It is similar to h split function, but split is basically vertical split is there, and this is array 1 and this is array 2. Now in next line, horizontal split using HTTP function with 2 arrays. So when we write 2 different variable name, so different array will be printed. This is array 1, this is array 2, this is array 1 and this is array 2. Next line, vertical split when we use two different variables. So this is array 1 and this is array 2. Next line, split of an array using a split function along x-axis. So only a single variable is used, so different array printed like this along axis 0. And when we used more than one variables, actually there are three different arrays when we perform a split function. This is first array, belongs to index 0. This is second array, belongs to index 1, 2, 3, and this is third array, belongs to fourth onwards. It is empty because let us check original array. This is an original array. This is index position 0, this is 1, this is 2, and this is 3. So there is no index, no array at index, no single dimensional array at index position 4. So there will be a empty array. Now this is a split function along axis 1, then we get this is along axis 0, next is axis 1, this is axis 2, this is axis 1, 2, 3, sorry, and this is 4 onwards. And when we use more three different variables names, then three different array will be printed. This is first array, this is second array, and this is third array. So now one thing should be very clear to all of you, that when we use a split function and we take a single variable, that means a single variable assigned to different split part. And when we use more than one variable, suppose after split we get three different part and we also take three different variables, then each part belongs to one variable, and then the different different parts will be printed in a different we can say that simple way. So try to assign different parts to different variable name, and it will take your work, it will make your work very easy, because after that printing statement, printing of that array will be very visible to all of you. Thank you for watching this video.